Welcome to Purani Jeans Se Pyar. 10 more days to go. Did you try to fit into your old jeans recently?
Actually, no. After the first day that I tried it, I thought I'm going to put it on the 45th day directly. Before that, I don't want any surprises. So I hope I fit into it.
I hope that too. Today, I'm going to focus on the leg muscles.
And I'm going to teach you how to make eggs in a green curry. So let's begin.
You will start your practice for today by performing 28 to 30 Surya Namaskar and then join us for a full body stretch. We are going to perform Supta Padangusthasana. Supta means lying down, and then we are working with legs, stretching the legs in different directions. So, lie down. Adjust your lower back. Hands apart. Tuck your tummy in very slowly. Use your core to lift your right leg up to 90 degrees. Slow, toes in, heel up, hold. If you can hold your toe, hold with the hand or hold your leg, wherever you can hold it. Your core is completely active. Try and fix your hips on the floor. Normal breathing. Now move your right leg to the right side as much as possible. You can take some support if you want, or you can keep your right leg off the floor and your head to the left side. Slowly get your leg in the middle, stretch. And move your right leg to the left side. Hold, use your left hand now. Release your right arm and go sideways as much as possible. You can stretch your right arm and look at the right side. Slowly come back in the middle. You can get your hands by the side of your body. Use your core completely active. Slowly go down. Keep pressing your lower back on the floor while going down. And relax. You will perform the same movement with your other leg. Now this stretch really works on stretching your legs completely, your hamstring muscles, your gluteal muscles. This is very good for any kind of back pain and knee pain. Now we are going to perform Akarna Dhanurasana. Hold your toes, arms stretched, hips firmly on the floor, lengthen your spine. Make yourself tall, feel tall. Now slightly bend your right knee. Try and fix the back of the left leg to the floor completely. Get a firm grip on your toes. Slowly raise your right leg up. You can hold your leg if you're not able to hold your toe, it's okay. Or you can just use some belt or dupatta, just put it around your this part and hold it like this, whatever is available. Up as much as possible, and slowly you're trying to get your right heel to your right ear. Slowly this way and stretch. Core in, your right elbow up and relax. Relax. Which part did you feel the stretch in?
The thighs.
Yes. So we were just trying to stretch this whole area. Also, the moment you start stretching it up, your arms will also become very active. So again, you'll have to perform this with the other leg. You can do it like thrice to begin with and try and hold each time for 20 to 30 seconds. 10 more days to go. And if you have not started for some reason, don't wait any longer. start now.
And now let's go into the kitchen and make that green curry. I assure you, you're gonna love it. Welcome to the Purani Jeans kitchen. Today I'm making eggs in green curry.
Now this is a new name to me. Is it something like Thai curry?
It's not like Thai curry at all. It's actually an Indian masala. And since you love greens so much, I thought let me do something different with eggs. What do you think?
I think you have started loving green too.
Absolutely. So let's begin. I've heated the pan. I'm going to start making the masala by adding in some mustard oil. Only about a teaspoon of mustard oil. The reason I'm using mustard oil is we often flavor different foods with different oils because it boosts the flavor. Mustard oil is also very good for health, and for greens it's really good to flavor the food. We need to wait for the mustard oil to smoke a little bit so that it's not raw and it doesn't give you that pungent flavor. I'm going to add in some whole spices, some bay leaf, about half an inch of cinnamon, 2 to 3 peppercorns, 2 to 3 cloves, and some cumin. Just about a pinch of cumin. And we need to brown these spices a little bit. Once these spices are slightly browned, I'm going to add in some garlic, chopped garlic. But I'm going to save some for later, just to flavor the curry in the end. Once the garlic is sautéed, I'm going to add in some slit green chilli. I like spicy food, so I'm going to add 2. If you don't like spicy food, you can add 1 or none. Now I'm going to add in some chopped onion to the pan. The pan has to be nice and hot. Also, in browning the onions, it helps if you have a wider pan. The flame has to be on high. And now I'm going to add in some salt to help brown the onion. Now the onion is almost brown. Now I'm going to lower the heat a little bit. And to this pan, here I have some freshly cleaned and shredded spinach. I've actually just torn the leaves. I'm just going to roughly tear them like this and just add them to the pan. This is very, very fresh spinach. I'm just going to saute. And I'm going to snip some coriander leaves just roughly. Don't forget the stems and the roots because they have a lot of flavor. A lot of times people tend to discard coriander roots, but actually they have the most flavor. In fact, in Thai curry, most people use coriander roots to make the Thai curry paste. I'm just going to remove this bay leaf now. And I'm going to let this masala cool down a bit before I make a paste of it. Once again, we heat the pan. I'm not adding any oil this time. The paste that I've made with the masala that we had prepared, I'm just going to add it into the pan. I'm going to allow the curry to simmer a little bit. The masala is already cooked, so we don't need to cook it much again. Just need to let it come to a boil. I'm now going to add in some chopped garlic into this. Now the reason I'm doing this is to give it a garlicky flavor, and also the texture will be really nice. This is almost done now. The only thing that we need to do is add some boiled eggs to it. I've already boiled eggs. Pieces of boiled egg that I'm simply going to add to this curry. More egg white, so I'm going to remove egg yolk in some and just add some egg white as well, and we're ready. For those of you who don't eat eggs, don't worry, just add in some boiled chickpeas and enjoy this curry.
And the good news, I love eggs, and I love this combination also.
That's great. The food tip for the day is, if you love eggs and you eat eggs, don't forget to add them in your diet because they're the quickest and the best source of protein that you can get.
I'm sure you'd have started noticing changes in your lifestyle by now. Keep watching us, share your views. Don't forget to subscribe. Till then, bye.